Example 1. Calculation fields in pivot tables. The data in this example's table shows the sales in dollars, units, and margin for 28 months, 8 countries, 5 product categories, 19 segments, and 30 brands. This table has 6,491 rows of data. Our task is to present this data in the form of a report that will be flexible and clear for users who do not necessarily have experience in using pivot tables. Just like in the lesson Pivot Tables for Beginners, we'll begin by inserting a pivot table. This process is shown in detail in that lesson, so if you aren't comfortable with simple pivot tables and haven't watched that lesson, please do so before continuing. After creating the pivot table, please drag month, market, and category into the filter fields. The order of the rows and columns fields can be changed at any time by dragging them from place to place. Drag the segment and brand fields into the row fields. Then drag sales 2019 and units 2019 into value fields and format them. Everything up to this point was covered in my Pivot Tables for Beginners lesson. Now we'll add the calculation field to our table. To add a calculated field from the Analyze tab, select Fields, Items and Sets, then Calculated Field. Of course, the Analyze tab is only visible when a cell within the pivot table is active. The Insert Calculated Field window is used to create formulas to calculate results that will be displayed in a pivot table. In this example, select the Sales 2019 field and press the Insert Field button. Then, from the keyboard, press the forward slash key. Then select the Sales 2018 field and press the Insert Field button again. Then finish the formula by adding -1. A column with the heading Sum of Field 1 was added to the pivot table. Since the change in the sales is a percentage, we'll change the format to percentages and change the description to sales change. Let's do some formatting now. For row 5, select Wrap Text and expand it so it is twice as wide as a regular row. I'll also add the Enter symbol to the headers. Then I'll move the column with the sales change to the left so it comes after sales 2019. We can now add a second calculation field with information on how the units changed compared to last year. You can enter the field name at this stage in the Name field, but it will be changed by Excel. And at this point, it isn't possible to just add Enter. Format the heading again, and then the numbers. The third calculated field will be the margin. In the source data, the margin is given as the value, so it's easy to just divide it by the sales and get the percentage margin. Using the techniques I've already shown you, format the field and change its name to margin percent. The last calculated field will be the change in the margin compared to last year. Instead of calculating the 2019 margin again, we'll use the margin percent field we just calculated. As you can see, previously created calculated fields can be used to create more complicated calculated fields without any problems. The change in the margin should be shown in percentage points, not percentages. Because there is no such format, we have to create it ourselves. In non-standard number formats, enter 0.0%p. A report in pivot table form has an advantage over normal tables, that is, it's very flexible. If, instead of dividing the segments into brands, we need to check which segments the brands are present in, just drag the segment field to the right. all the calculated fields work correctly, regardless of the combination of filters used or the sequence of headers. Of course, this isn't the only option. We can also, for example, drag the category field to the rows and the brands field to the filters, which will divide the category into segments. There are many possibilities to experiment with. Example 2. The datasheet is APT2 and the finished exercise sheet is APT3. We were asked to determine how many products had sales below 100, above 800, and in the threshold of 50, between 100 and 800. Let's insert a pivot table and move the product name to the value fields and the sales to the row field, which is a rather unusual layout. The formatting of the pivot table is the same as the format that was selected for the previous pivot table that we worked on. Therefore, the format of the table you see during this exercise may differ from the one shown in this video. Right-click on the Sales column and select Group. In the Grouping pane, enter the beginning and the end of the interval which you want to group by, and the value of the threshold between 100 and 800. Then press OK. The result fulfills the requirements of this exercise. The names of the products have been counted, and now we know exactly how many there are in each group. This result can be further added to with the sales of each of these ranges, the share of the sales, and the share of the number of products. All of these operations were explained in detail in my previous lesson, so as not to prolong this lesson, I won't go into that now. Many interesting conclusions can be drawn from a table like this. For example, it can immediately be seen that 50 products with sales below 100 constitute as much as 10% of all the products offered, and they generate less than 1% of the sales. Example 3. Datasheet APT3. Continuing to work on the pivot table from the previous example, I'd like to show you quite a convenient trick. Often, we want to quickly enter a formula into the sheet that counts on something based on the data from the pivot table. For example, we'll check whether the sales shares in column E have been calculated correctly, independently calculating the share on the basis of the data from column C. Unfortunately, it turns out that Excel records pivot table references in a rather complicated way. The formula works for the first cell, but cannot easily be copied down. Formulas cannot be copied even after removing the dollar signs, because the references to the cells are not addresses, but field descriptions. For example, the less than sign denotes the first of the grouping intervals. To stop the getPivotData function being generated automatically, select Options from the Analyze tab, then untick Generate getPivotData. Now we can write formulas for any other range that can also be easily copied. Keep in mind that if the table changes, the formula will still use the same references. Another example is the calculation of the average sales per product for every range. Adding formulas outside the pivot table that use pivot table data is useful to calculate something quickly, but isn't really a professional use of pivot tables. Example 4. APT4. In this example, we'll also group the data, but in ranges of different sizes. Unequal thresholds for a lot of economic and social data are much more suitable for analysis. For example, with price data, whereas the sales of products from the value and mass segments need to be divided into multiple smaller ranges, and the prices of the premium products are much more diverse. We'll start by preparing a pivot table based on the data in the APT4 spreadsheet. We'll drag sales to both the rows and the values. For the sum of sales, select Show Values As, and then select Percentage of Grand Total. Let's choose the products with a sales value below 50. Cells A4 to A28. Right-click on any cell in this area and group them by selecting Group as usual. The newly created group has been automatically called Group 1. In the formula bar, we can change its name to less than 50. At this point, please ignore the changes to the rows below. After double-clicking on cell A4 or single-clicking on the dash symbol in this cell, the group collapses, and column B shows the sales share for the whole group. Now we'll group, change the names, and hide the elements of the following groups. 50 to 200, 200 to 400, 400 to 500, 500 to 600, 600 to 900, and more than 900. Grouping is possible on many levels. After selecting the first two groups and selecting group, we get a new grouping level and a total for the groups. Please check out the report layout options under the Design tab, since outline form is much more intuitive for some people than the default compact form. To ungroup a group of any level, right-click on its name and select Ungroup. To connect two groups without creating another grouping level, first ungroup them, then group them as one again. In our example, we'll join the less than 50 and 50 to 200 groups together. The old groups now cease to exist, and a new group has been created in their place, the name of which can be changed to less than 200. In this exercise, we base the pivot table on the data in the APT4 sheet, but the same data is also in the APT2 sheet. If we used the same source data for both tables, problems could arise. If the data has already been grouped in another pivot table, Excel can also group them in the same way in a second pivot table. In that case, right-click on the groups and select Ungroup. This connection works both ways. The changes made in the grouping will also be entered into the first pivot table. The simplest solution to avoid problems like this is to copy the datasheet and use a different one for each of the tables that we are working on. It isn't possible to combine equally ranged automatic grouping with grouping that has unequal intervals. You can find more practical examples in the lesson Pivot Tables for Experts. One of our subscribers wrote, "What previously took me 8 hours is now possible in just one." Send the link to this course to your friends. We're sure that they will appreciate your recommendation. And that's the end of that lesson.